My dear friends, myself Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, and we are going to discuss a very important topic known as probability in this video. So whenever probability comes in your mind, you find some synonyms of this probability, possibility, chance, like these words appear in your mind. So if I ask you a question that India and Australia played 10 matches in a series and India won 6 matches and Australia won 4 matches, none of the matches were drawn. So I expect that if a next match will be played, if 11th match will be played, whose chances of winning are higher. So of course, what will you say? Because whenever it comes to mathematics, mathematics is already developed in our mind. So our mind says, our prediction says, on the basis of comparison, on the basis of logic, that India may win the match. Why? Because in last 10 matches, India won more matches than Australia. So the same concept is here in probability, that the number of trials in which the event happened means in how many matches India won. India won in 6 matches. And how many matches were played? 10 matches were played. Therefore, chances of winning of India, probability of winning of India, probability of winning of India is what? P stands for probability. Probability of winning of India is what? 6 upon 10. Probability of winning of Australia is what? Probability of winning of Australia is 4 upon 10. Means how many matches India won? 6 matches out of 10. So it is like this. You can read in other way that it is what? 6 out of 10. And it is 4 out of 10. And one more example we can discuss over here. Whenever you come after the examination of a particular paper, your parents used to ask that how many percentage you are going to score in this paper, then you express your feeling that I am going to score more than what? More than 90% or more than 80%, means my chances are going to score 90%, means I can score how much? 90 marks out of 100. If your paper is of 100 marks, if your paper is of 80 marks or 50 marks, accordingly there will be a change. So this is what? This is again, what is this? This is probability. What do you say to your parents? You used to say that my chances of scoring in mathematics paper is 90%, means out of 100 I may score 90. So what is this? 90 out of 100. Let's discuss few more examples so that the concept of probability will become more sound to us. If a coin is tossed 100 times, if a coin is tossed 100 times, let's consider an example. A coin is tossed 100 times. And this kind of experiments you can do yourself. And I suggest you to do 100 times, and 30 times head appears, 30 times H appears, and 70 times tail appears, or tails, whatever you say. So probability of P means probability of getting what? Head. How many heads were there? So out of 100, 30 times we got head. So probability of head would be 30 upon 100, and similarly probability of tail will be 70 upon 100. So it's a very, very interesting and common phenomena. But whenever head and tail comes in your mind and someone asks you it, because it is a very general question, whenever someone asks you that if a coin is tossed, what is the probability of getting a head? You used to say that it is 50%. What is the probability of getting a tail? It is 50%. But in this coin, it is not happening. So why is it so? It is because of the number of experiments are limited. Number of experiments are limited. If you will increase number of experiments, suppose these experiments were 100 times. Even you can do this kind of experiment yourself. You toss a coin 10 times and note how many times you got head and how many times you got tail. And if you perform this experiment many times, means 1000 times, 10,000 times, then you will come to this experience that approx 50% times you get head, and approx 50% times you get tail. But this will happen if you increase your number of trials, number of experiments. So what is number of experiment, number of trials? So the phenomena which is going to happen again and again, and you do the experiment again and again. So when means number of experiment is called number of trials, and the number of our choice, what we expect is called event. So, and one more thing you can notice, that probability of an event cannot be, probability of any event cannot be greater than 1. Why this cannot be greater than 1? Why is it so? Because whenever if you toss a coin 100 times, then what would appear? Either head or tail. Nobody would ask you to find of getting 3, because 3 is not related with this event. So if someone asks you that what is the, if a coin is tossed 100 times, what is the probability of getting 3, then what would you say? Then you would say that its chances are getting 3 is 0, because 3 is not related with this event. So a probability of an event can be what? At least means its least value can be 0 and its greatest value can be 1, but it cannot be greater than 1, because these things, 30 times head, 30, 70 times tail, how these come? These come from these, from this event, from this performance. So performance, this number of trials can never exceed these two, means sorry, number of trials cannot be less than these two things, because these two things are part of this. They are not independent, they are part of this. So this means number of events, n of e means number of events, can not be greater than number of trials. Means what you expect, you expect from trials. So trials cannot be trials cannot be less than this. Okay, so you note down this thing, that probability of an event cannot be less than zero, means it cannot be negative, and it cannot be what? It cannot be more than one. It cannot be more than one. Let's consider one more example. There are 10 families. There are 10 families, and you can do this kind of experiment nearby your home. There are 10 families, and I am writing a record of those 10 families. 10 families, and in these 10 families, 5 families have 2 boys, number of boys. 5 families have 2 boys. 2 families have 3 boys. And 3 families have only 1 boy in their family. So, what is this? Number of families. And if I ask you, what is the probability? Means, what is the probability that in these 10 families, how many families are there? There are 10 families. In these 10 families, how many, means possibility of the families having 2 boys. So the family which are having 2 boys, they are 5. And the total number of families are 10. Therefore, the probability of having 2 boys from these families will be 5 upon 10. Probability of having 4 boys will be what? Probability of having 4 boys will be what? 0. Probability of having 1 boy is, how many families are having only 1 boy? 3 families are having 1 boy, so probability is 3 upon 10. And probability of having at least one boy means we are concerned with the families which are having at least 1 boy, means the family which are having only 1 boy, good. Having 2 boys, very good. And having 3 boys, best. So how many such families are there having 1 boy, 2 and 3? They all are having 3, 2, 5. Means how many families are there? There are 10 families, and all the 10 families satisfying this condition. So what is probability? Probability is 1. Probability is 0. If probability is 0, then it means event. What we are expecting is called event. So our expectancy event is impossible event. Impossible means such kind of events cannot happen. And if probability is 1, we used to say that Event is a sure event. And we will be discussing more on this probability connection to this lecture in next video. So I request you to watch the next video so that your concept will be more clear. Wish you good luck for the next video.